Master Witcher, some unknown individual barged into the residence. I resisted as best I could, but to no avail.
Who is it?
Alas, they did not do me the basic courtesy of introducing themselves.
In the flesh.
I thought you were in Kavir.
I got tired of waiting for you, so I decided to head to Toussaint. Catch some sun, see how things are going. You said it would only take a moment.
Things are pretty much wrapped up, luckily. We'll be able to head north soon.
I hope you're not upset I came like this, without warning.
True, I haven't always been fond of surprises. They remind me of work, the law of surprise, surprise child. But I think I've changed my mind. Seems surprises can actually be pleasant. Very pleasant. Let's go outside. There's this one cozy spot you're gonna love. How are things in Kavir?
Amazingly boring and predictable. Council meetings mainly concern trade matters. Tariffs, storage regulations, that sort of thing.
Missing the excitement?
You know the Atheri saying, may you live in interesting times? Well, I've already done that, and now I'm looking for a bit of quiet. The other mages I brought with me from Novigrad, or who made it north on their own, feel the same. You wouldn't recognize them. No conspiracies, cabals, plotting. They just sit there and work for the good of the kingdom. Sometimes I think it's all too lovely to be true. That something's bound to happen. Another war or some other horror. But for now, it's nice. And once you finish your business here and come join me, it'll be even better.
So, how do you like my vineyard?
I think you know the answer to that. I like it a lot. House is big, but not showy. Lovely location. Perfect for romantic getaways.
Just finished some remodeling. Paid through the nose for it, but I think it was worth it. There are already some new saplings and flowers around the grounds, but I think it's still missing something. Maybe a hedge maze? With a statue in the center? One that's stately and nude.
Ugh, Geralt, don't bring up that ball. The wine got to my head and I...
Not bringing it up to tease, but to reminisce. That evening, it was magic. And your dress. You looked lovely in it.
I've got it with me. I could put it on one evening. We'll dine outside by candlelight, listen to the music of the cicadas.
Can't wait. How'd you find me? Kavir's a long way off.
I have my ways, Geralt. Hydromancy, for example.
Oh yeah, that's right. So, what becomes of us? See anything else in the reflection?
Zoltan moves in.
Please tell me you're joking.
You can breathe easy. Far as I know, he settled down in Novigrad and has no intention of budging. In all seriousness, though, I did see a few scraps of our future, but I'd rather not tell you exactly what.
Why not?
Because you said you've grown to like pleasant surprises.
This is your first time in Toussaint, right? Want me to show you around a bit?
Sorry, but I've already made plans.
Oh? What are you going to do?
Lie down in the sun, and not move an inch.
Ah, right. A packed schedule. Not overdoing it a tad.
Oh, gotta get the most of this weather before I return north. Know that joke about how to tell when summer's come to Kavir?
The rain isn't quite so cold.
And sadly, that's not far from the truth. Oh, I shouldn't have told you that. Now you'll change your mind and not come join me.
I wouldn't worry about that. Mind if I leave you here alone for a moment?
Just a moment.
Geralt, here at last.
Dandelion? What the hell are you doing here?
I'm not here. I'm a figment of your imagination, because you really want me to be here. Brought you a housewarming gift. It's also an illusion. How do you like it?
Makes you look dignified and manlier than in real life.
Does it? The painter's a friend of mine. Could be she gave me slightly broader shoulders? Well, I'm sure.
Don't doubt it. But didn't I see this painting at your place?
This is its perfect replica, and it's yours. To remember me by. Good. So, Geralt, important to remember. If anyone asks, I'm not here. Last time I was in Toussaint, enjoying myself, true, Honorietta, that is, the Duchess, got a little carried away. Banished me from the duchy on pain of death. Wouldn't want to ruffle her feathers without cause.
Wise, especially since she's been through quite a bit recently.
I've heard some rumors, but I'd love a first-hand account. Does it have the makings of a ballad? Well, going to show me around? Tell me the story?
Of course. Let's go. Luckily, Sianna made up with Honorietta. Seems to have abandoned her plans. She's locked up now, awaiting sentencing, really. Most think the Duchess will forgive her. Might take some time, but...
What? A story? Seems I missed quite a lot. Shame I didn't ride here with you. Though, truth be told, had my hands full back home as well.
What's new, old friend?
Everything's fine. Great. Thanks to you, I'm with a woman I'm entirely devoted to. Surrendered my heart to.
Didn't have all that much to do with that.
If you hadn't been there, Priscilla would have died a cruel death. And right about now, I'd be drowning my sorrows in some dive with piss-stained walls.
Hope she's better.
She had the best medics around. Wounds have all healed. She's confident, outgoing. She's got places to go and folk to see. And in the alcove. I mean, can you imagine she...
Dandelion, I can't imagine, and I won't.
All right. But your loss.
How's business? You and Zoltan still have your tavern? Or has he embarked on some new venture?
You know him. We'll share a jug of mead, and he'll go on about some new plan he's got. Nothing ever comes of it. So, we're still there. Recently, we discovered Novigrad's largest wine importer was a lying cheat, watering down his wines, but so clever, you'd never taste the difference.
So how'd you figure out he was up to something?
This one day I was feeling down in the muck, decided to lift my spirits by, well, getting a little drunk. Actually, replace a little with really. So I knocked back a bottle, nothing. Then another, maybe a slight buzz.
Might not be a lightweight anymore. Could be those years of training have finally paid off.
Come on! It took me 5 bottles to start seeing double. I thought, might just be a weird day. So I tried the same thing the next morning. Exact same result. I told Zoltan. He tried it and confirmed my findings. So we decided to ask the importer some tough questions. The man cracked. I threatened to tell everyone about his trickery unless he gave me a discount.
Plan to stay long?
Don't know yet, but might stay a little while. I've always loved Beauclair. The place is made for poets.
What'll you do here?
City's full of knights-errant, and they all want ballads immortalizing their deeds. Get this. I've already been approached by a knight who spent years battling the weather. Says he's got a real bone to pick with gusty storms.
Battles the weather? How's that work?
Dunno. Promised to show me when the time was right. There's another who's vowed to move a mountain that's blocking his ailing mother's view of the sunset. So he's moving it. One stone at a time. Sole worry is that his mama won't live to see him finish.
You're right. Prime ballad material there. Glad you came. We'll have some good talks. See you later, Dandelion.
See you, Witcher.
What's that smell?
You look good. Come, don't just stand there. I want a hug.
What did you bring?
A garkin from Angryn. I slew it. All by my lonesome.
That why you left Carrera so suddenly? Had no idea where you'd gone. Your note was puzzling. Don't try to find me. Threw me for a loop.
That was silly. It's just that I felt stifled in your shadow. I'd have suffocated had I stayed. So when I read that notice, the contract, when I saw Angryn, I knew I had to do it. Alone. Without my nanny.
I'm not your nanny. I believe in you. Like my new house?
The house is lovely. But it could use a bit of work.
Yeah, got plans for it, don't worry. Wanna go outside? Could show you the grounds.
Ah, it's lovely here. I could stay forever.
What's stopping you?
Actually, not a thing. I slew a garkin, collected my bounty. I believe I'm owed some respite.
Indeed you do, mademoiselle, as my majordomo would say.
You've a butler?
A steward. Name's Barnabas Basil. BB for short, though I don't know if he likes it. He's the one let you in. I'll ask him to bring in some fruit, a beverage. You can spend the rest of the day lying about.
Nothing would make me happier.
Being a witcher, anything like you imagined?
Geralt, I didn't have to imagine anything. Remember, before we parted, we walked a good stretch of the path together.
Journeyman and master, though, not the same thing.
I'm still a long way from mastering anything, but I am trying. Anyway, I did learn from the best.
Just passed on what worked for me. Or at least tried to.
I was thinking of Eskel and Lambert.
So, no regrets? Choice you made?
Not at all. I'm doing what I ever wanted to do. Being who I wanted to be. I believe that's one definition of happiness.
Encountered the most charming aspect of being a witcher yet?
Which aspect is that?
The hatred. Disgust. That strange blend of admiration, fear, and contempt.
They set their hands on me in one village. In another, they forbade me from taking a drink from their well. Other than that, it's been all right. No one's tried to cheat me out of my reward so far.
I'd hoped they'd treat a woman differently.
Geralt, when they treat a woman differently in this world, it hardly ever means better. Quite the opposite.
Engrin, how'd it go? Garkanes can be pretty tough opponents.
That's why I had to lure this one to a place both spacious and empty, where it would have nowhere to hide. I found an abandoned crypt far from any town or village.
Good choice. Always best to avoid additional casualties, so your foe had nowhere to hide. But the bastard was still damn quick, I bet.
Not as quick as I am. My greater worry was its strength. I was far outclassed there. But a dose of black blood did the trick. We fought a while, I feigned a mistimed dodge and let it drink. The rest was easy.
See you later, Ciri.
Take care of yourself.
All in all, best part of the whole ceremony? It was short.
Perhaps for you, as you ducked out early. The others are probably just getting started. The drunkenness never ends in this quaint realm.
Not so fond of Toussaint after all, are we?
Oh, this place is like a strong wine, Geralt. Good in small sips. How do you find my personal brew? Not too strong.
Just right.
Credit the local mandrake of the Alrauna Diavolus variety for that. The tubers which grow in this area's volcanic soil have an altogether unique flavor profile and display a remarkably uncommon dark brown tint.
Fascinating. All I can say is this batch turned out excellent.
Indeed. It might be wise to stockpile some roots for the future. Would you care to accompany me?
You decide to go root picking now? It's dark out.
Ah, Geralt. Even were I generously to assume it had simply slipped your mind that I am a vampire and thus need no light to see, I'd never believe you had also forgotten that you likewise have absolutely no trouble seeing in the dark. So, shall we?
If you think it's a good idea, let's go. But I think you might be forgetting one thing. Fresh mandrake root of this variety is highly toxic. Even to a witcher.
Ah, not a problem. I never forget matters of safety and hygiene in alchemy. Here, gloves and a mask. Don them, and you shall be in no danger.
Thanks. Right then, let's go.
This moonlight makes me oh so dreamy.
Penny for your thoughts. Let me guess. Succubus twins?
No, I was thinking about, how anything can look interesting when properly lit.
Even an old necrophage corpse?
You've not an ounce of refinement in you, have you?
That bloodsucker go? Won't be easy to track down. He's a vampire after all. Damn it, where'd you go? Where'd you go? Those Bruxay, they called you a traitor.
Alas, we've a very simple code of honor, we vampires. So simple you might call it trivial. Either one is with us, unconditionally, regardless of the circumstances, or...
Won't let it go, will they?
They will not. Fortunately, we've another rule, an unwritten one, and just as trivial as the first. It is neatly summarized in the saying, out of sight, out of mind. That is why I must leave Toussaint. For a vastly long time, most like.
Yeah, I get it.
Let us make for my camp. I've an overwhelming desire to have another drink.
Supreme bouquet. Firm, defined beginning, then develops gently, rising to a startling finish. Don't you think?
Not much of a connoisseur.
Then it is high time you started your education. After all, the Corvo Bianco vineyard is now yours. By the way, I left a gift for you at your new home, on the nightstand.
Thanks. Mind telling me what it is?
A trifle. That will nonetheless be useful should you need mutagens. Incidentally, have you thought about what you'll do with your prize? Shall you hang your swords over the mantle and take to pruning vines?
No, just not the life for me. Sure, might stop by there occasionally, stay the winter, fill up on wine. But I'd rather keep moving. It's not a choice being a Witcher. And once you are one, you're one for life. You can't just step off the path. Besides, plenty of work left for me in the world. Ghouls aren't gonna kill themselves.
Rather droll, isn't it, that each time we meet, something harrowing must happen? I can remember a night, not too far from here, if I'm not mistaken. We hid in a cave while a blizzard raged all about. Does that sound at all familiar?
How could it not? We just set off to rescue Ciri from Vilgefortz.
Oh, our encounter with Vilgefortz. That is something I do not remember so fondly. But that first stay in Beauclair, far calmer than this one.
Seemed like a land straight out of a fairy tale back then. Its sole problem, cellars too small to accommodate all that wine.
Appearances, Geralt. Appearances like Mamoons and Dopplers deceive. So what did become of Vilgefortz?
Killed him. Sure wasn't easy, though. What about you? Any idea where you'll go?
Distance is of the essence. I thought I might venture south.
Nilfgaard?
Why ever not? The Nilfgaardians are a modern society. None there believe in vampires anymore. This fact alone could be very useful to one wishing to remain incognito.
Interesting point of view. I so don't feel like going anywhere. Sit here a while longer?
So we shall, my friend. We have witnessed, and in fact on several occasions incited, many great and weighty events. After all that toil, I believe we deserve a bit of a rest.
That we do.
When a humble bard graced to ride at home with Geralt of Rivia, along came this song. From when the wild wolf fought a silver tone devil, his army of hells, his hooves the day revel. They came after me with massive foam to see, broke down my loot and they kicked in my teeth. Wild at the foe's horns, men so tender me, and so cried a witcher, he can't be bleed. Toss a coin to your witcher, O Valley of Plenty, O Valley of Plenty. Toss a coin. Lectures and brains you and bring to the morn. He thrusts every elf far back on the shelf, high up on the mountain from whence he came. Yeah! He wiped out your past, cracked it in his chest. He's a friend of humanity, so give him the rest. That's my epic tale, a champion prevailed, defeated a villain, now buy him some hail. Toss a coin to your witcher, O Valley of Plenty, O Valley of Plenty, oh. Toss a coin.
Thank you.